Welcome, welcome, faithful listeners, to Let's Play Wiz and Liz number 5. I'm Duke of the Bump. Joining me tonight are my good friends, Lemon, and Banana, and the lovely Potato, which I can't mix with the other two. Just in case you were wondering. Time ahoy. Wow. That must have given me a bunch of time or something. I don't know, I didn't notice what the timer said before. Alright, well, I have a potato. Let's find something tasty to make. Let's make some latkes. You know what sounds good? Potatoes and onions. Hash browns. Delicious. Dangerously greasy. The onion looks kind of like one of those giant Fritos. You ever see those things? Not a sausage, mate. That's a British expression, meaning you don't get anything for that spell. So I just wasted 90 stars. Alright, well, on with the game. Unlucky number 13. Maybe Time Ahoy causes a bunch of time icons to be released or something. That would be kind of cool. Well, that's not a time icon. Didn't see what that was. Maybe it releases more than usual? I don't know. I guess I should really pay more attention to these things. I realize I'm going too fast for you to really see anything, but the backgrounds on this game are actually pretty awesome. Like, in one of the desert land levels, there's a Statue of Liberty. Damn. Maybe time icons are worth more? I think that might be it. But there's a Statue of Liberty buried to his chest in the sand in an homage to Planet of the Apes, which is kind of cool. And I think there's a reference to Posey in one of the levels, too. There's like a tombstone for Posey or something. Or maybe I'm thinking of something else. Psygnosis is always putting references to other games in their games. Like, there's a spell that causes lemmings to appear in the level, which, again, don't do anything. Most of the spells in this game are really just for show, now that I think of it. Okay, that's a lot of time icons. That's pretty good. They're either for show or just for amusement. Okay, yeah, time icons are definitely worth more. That's a pretty handy spell. Bonus letter. I love the sound. The sound effects in this game are great too, along with the music. They're just so satisfying. I mean, it's kind of basic, you know, plinks and bloops video game sounds, but I mean, as big of a Genesis fanboy as I am, I would admit that the Super Nintendo usually has better music and sound. But I think this is one of the examples that proves that if you push it, the Genesis can really hold its own. I mean, I know, you know, with me talking and everything, you haven't really been able to appreciate the music in this game. But it's actually quite good. I linked to the intro music for this game. Hey, I didn't know that was a bonus level. In the sidebar. Oh yeah, guess the words. This is where you actually get to find out what some of these words mean. Or not. But yeah, I linked to the intro music, and you should definitely check that out, because it is some fine music. I want to bet the whole hog. Why not? It's all or nothing. The word frickle means being a dwarf, playing the guitar, ale, beer, or lager, a basket for carrying bushels. Frickle. Well, it doesn't sound like a verb. It sounds more like an adjective. But none of these are really adjectives. Well, dwarf is an adjective, but the act of being is not really. This doesn't seem to make grammatical sense. I'll go with D. Hey, awesome. I just made 35 stars. Should I go double or nothing? Let's stick with 35 for now. The word skewbald. You know, I guess I could go look these up real quick. Although really, I'm not even sure these are real words or not. I mean, maybe they're just making up words and definitions to go along with them. Brown, black, and white horse. Well, it's probably not going to be D again, since it was D last time. I want to go with the pot. Ah! See, when you're wrong, it doesn't tell you what the right answer is. It's infuriating. Let's give it another shot. The word squiffer. I don't like the sound of that. Sounds a little too close to something. I'm not going to go there. Covered in blisters. See, it doesn't sound like an adjective. It sounds like a noun. Doesn't sound like a jail. Strong white Chinese porcelain. I bet it's someone who plays an organ. That sounds right. Yes! Squiff that organ. Alright, you know what? Enough fooling. Oh, 50 is a max. That sucks. I don't know how many rounds it goes. Might go until you run out of stars. Bingle. Let's see. Heavy drinker. Baseball term for a base hit. I never heard of that. Sounds kind of like a boat. A bingle. Everybody get in the bingle! I'll go with that. Ah! Now I only have 20. You know, gambling is a fool's game. You never come out ahead. The house always wins. Trolleywags. Ugh. These all sound wrong. Maybe these are like slang terms or something. Because honestly, none of these sound like real words. I can see the meaning trousers, though. I might put on your trolley wags. I'll go with that. Awesome. Up, game over. I came out 5 stars ahead. Woo! I think that's the first time I've ever come out ahead in that game. That's always a fun one. Oh, there's the Statue of Liberty. It's buried a little deeper than I thought it was. I don't think I've gotten a single invisible letter yet. And I'm probably gonna die. Oh, I heard it. Ah! Why does the time icon have like a little hammer on it? Maybe that means it's hammer time. Oh snap! I went there! I wonder what MC Hammer's up to these days. I think he like got all religious or something. Which, you know, most big musicians who become train wrecks later in life end up becoming religious. Like, I can't think of any examples off the top of my head, but you know, it always happens. Andy Griffith? Of course, I guess he was probably always religious. And he wasn't really a musician. Oh, he is, but I mean, it's not what he's known for. Let's see, who are some other musicians who ended up going to God? So, how about that awkward change of subject, huh? Pretty abrupt. Man, let me tell you, I don't know why I'm collecting cabbage. I hate this stuff. I hate it in the game almost more than I do in real life. And boiled cabbage is one of the most disgusting things in the world. Not just boiled. Pretty much anything you can do to cabbage is disgusting. Except coleslaw. Coleslaw is pretty good. But, you know, the cabbage in that is raw. Which is the way it should be. Basically, any process that you can apply to cabbage, cooking it or fermenting it or anything, turns it rather disgusting. Oh no! And I had such a good streak going too, with no invisible letters. And I finally got one. What really sucks is getting an invisible letter or having a wabbit die when there are almost no wabbits left. Because you have to wait for more wabbits to spawn, and it takes forever. You know, I should really keep a chart or something telling me what I have and haven't mixed. Because I don't remember any of this shit. I think I'm going to do that. After this, I'm going to go back and look at my old videos. Temple Land skipped. Huh. I don't remember if I've done that yet or not. But yeah, I'll keep a chart by my monitor so I can remember what combinations I have and haven't tried. Have I gotten that one? Oh no, I got not a sausage. So you've seen both of the spells, they give you absolutely nothing. And it looks like we're just about at the 10 minute mark. I don't think I want to be doing any shopping just yet. Although I want to have to beef up my extra lives a little bit, probably. Alright, well, thanks for watching. As always, I'm Dooku the Bump. I will see you whenever the next time happens to be.